you both. Okay, we have the regular meeting minutes from May 1st.
They looked accurate to me.
Okay. Take those motion, I'll second.
DJ?
Yes.
Mike?
Yes.
Okay. Bid openings at 8 o'clock. Come back to those.
Very good.
And we have guest speakers tonight. And we'll start out with Tucker Eshelman, 301.
Guys.
Come up, let's know what you're...
So I'm presenting my Eagle Scout project. I was, it was a bocce court at Auburn Community Parks.
Okay.
So this is where I thought it was going to be, next to the playground. I know that they're going to do an addition on the playgrounds later this summer.
That's going right now, actually.
Oh. Right, I don't know if that conflicts with that.
Okay. Well, that, Hammer, do you want to take a look at potential location for a bocce court? He's got it down at the end of a playground. I don't know if there's any safety ramifications of having it that close to the playground.
No.
Whacking little kids in the head with balls or anything?
I wouldn't think so.
Okay.
That playground's under construction right now, mm-hmm. So okay. It'll look a little different than the picture.
I think PG tomorrow morning they're done.
Yeah,
they're clicking out.
Yeah, so I mean, in that general vicinity, I wouldn't see a problem with that. So we might confirm exactly how much space you're going to have available there.
Okay.
What are the dimensions on a bocce court?
The one I want to do is maybe like 8 feet by 70 feet.
Okay.
And like the standard is like 13 by 91, which is going to work really well.
Okay, real important to get with Emmerich for a location there.
Okay.
Yep.
Well, yeah, I think that would
cool
be
a cool idea.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Okay.
Hey, Tuck, before you sit down, you got
to... Yeah, there might be something there.
Somewhere you're going to have Auburn Township on there. I just signed my name as trustee, so.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, thanks.
Okay. And also Sarah Eshelman.
So, I was here, I think in August last year, to do my, who's going to do a little free library,
mm-hmm.
Which is one of these, also in the Auburn Community Park. And I actually met with my advisor for the project, and she mentioned that just doing the library by itself was probably not going to be enough for the project. So I worked together with her, and we decided that adding like maybe a bench and a tree or some kind of like small garden around it to make it more of a like reading area or reading garden would be kind of a better idea. So I went back to the park and found a couple of places that I thought might be, I took a bunch of pictures, so. That might be good for that little area, but I wanted to see what you thought about that.
So what's the rank or whatever that you're going for? Like, I know he's Eagle Scout.
Oh, I'm sorry. I'm doing my Gold Award project.
Gold Award?
Yeah.
For Girl Scouts.
So I was thinking, this is like very front of the, of the trail, and how it would be kind of thing at the inside, but I didn't know what kind of plants or anything I could put with that. But I could definitely put like a bench and some sort of small area around that.
Yeah, anything in the woods we have to clear with the conservancy. They hold an easement on there, and they've been real easy to work with. I think there's some benches in there in various places. Halfway around, didn't we get a proposal for some benches?
I don't think anything like that, they really have a problem with.
Probably not, but we always inform them because we're supposed to go.
And if not, like somewhere near the playground or around the building, I don't know if that would be better or if you want to.
Wasn't the library going to be the little, going to be somewhere like right in here?
Yeah, I was planning on either attaching it to one of the posts on the building or doing it sort of close to that area or very close to the playground so that it could be where the parents and kids would be. But if you still want me to do it there, that's perfectly fine. That was another option.
Well, we were just doing that partially to protect the library itself from the elements.
Yeah. And I can make it totally.
I mean, we do something in conjunction with that where.
It's a great idea.
I mean,
it'll get used, I'm sure.
You know, if we could take something and, have a library by one of the posts and then a bench or something, nearby, close to the. And I think, something like on this side facing the playground would give some additional seating for. For parents, too, that are
watching their kids.
So, kind of look at it, I think, from this standpoint of this area here.
Okay.
And maybe you can sketch something up then from, conjunction. Because now we're pretty much finishing up the playground for the expansion of it.
Yeah.
So everything now is set, so you'll be able to go in there and really see where we're going.
Okay.
Plus, we're having some work done at the park from a landscaping standpoint. And we also have information on what's being done there, so we'll be able to coordinate around all those things. So.
Perfect.
But yeah, I think it's a great idea. And so if you just need approval to...
Yeah, I think up near the playground is a better...
Okay.
Yeah, it just makes more
Would
sense.
Would you rather have it closer to the building or like near the playground? There's like somewhere in between?
There isn't a whole lot of room there. I mean, six, one and a half dozen the other.
I'd say, like I said, we were only looking at... the building itself for protection.
Right, exactly.
If it's protected enough itself in the elements, then...
It should be, with the plans that I have
working
on.
Yeah, then you can just move it away from the building and just kind of bring up just a small central area.
Okay.
Somewhere between the playground and the building itself.
Awesome. Cool.
All right, thank you.
Do you want to keep these pictures, or...?
Well, like I said, we know where it's going to go now, so what we really need is, a final sketch and a location.
Okay.
And once again, get with Emmerich before any shovels hit the dirt. So,
okay.
Yep.
And then, at some point, we'll need like a letter of approval. If you want me to write that up, I can send it in. Like.
Girl Scouts do the forms that the Boy Scouts do?
Not really. They're not as nice as Boy Scouts are, but... I can...
Yeah, if you want to just format a letter and just put down the specifics of your project, then just bring it up and we can sign off on that for you.
Yeah, thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Mike, we got one more scout here that's walked in. He's going to give us an update on his Eagle project that he proposed last year.
David Cavanaugh, Troop 101. I was here last fall, I believe, to present my Eagle Scout project, just like Parker just did, but... That went fine. I got all my signatures. I'm just here now to refresh a little bit on exactly what mine was. Last time I was here, I had a couple of pictures on my phone of what my project was basically going to be. But I had Kendra and Brescia help me out with some design as far as my project. And my project is going to be a kiosk. Let's see if I can find it. Yeah, this is a... Sorry, I couldn't get it in color. That's basically what it's going to look like. I'm building the kiosk itself, and then I am mapping the trail in the woods. And as far as the location of my kiosk, I wanted to put it somewhere right around there. You shall have there's a little island of grass between the trail and the parking lot in the woods. And I just wanted to put it all right there. I just wanted to present this one more time. Like I said, I have received donations. I have not asked yet. I've gotten quotes for lumber, and I'm going to get a quote soon for the map. And I just wanted to quick refresh.
Yeah, drawing. Sure, yeah, drawing of the building.
Conflicts
with the dimensions.
I have a drawing of the structure itself with all the dimensions. It's what I used to get lumber quotes.
Okay.
The quotes put us somewhere in between $500 and $600. So I'm all.
And do you have a schedule?
I do have a schedule, actually. as far as dating and all of this, these are all kind of estimates still. But I have to have all of this finished and over with by sometime before my birthday in order to fill out all the paperwork necessary to treat Eagle Scout and all that. Either way, I plan on fundraising after this is clear, unless there are any conflicts, which I don't imagine. And on fundraising, as soon as I can, next weekend, possibly, the weekend after that, latest. June, I plan on obtaining materials for this, and that's after, of course, I get enough donations. As soon as I get the proper materials, we're going to be clearing the build site. After that, that'll also hopefully be in June. And then late June into July, I hope to start actually getting work dates on weekends to construct my kiosk. And hopefully that'll get done before sometime mid-August when school's about to start back up. And I can just worry about paperwork after that. And the map itself, that can get done anytime between now and before my birthday, or whenever I turn in my paperwork, because I could keep the map in my room if need be. It's just the construction of that.
You're going to get with them, Rick, too, once again, like everybody, before a shovel hits the ground there, so we know where the holes are.
Any questions?
No. I think it's right where you left off on the project when you talked to us the first time, so we proved it at that point, so I think we're in good shape.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you, David. And there's David on Cleveland.com today, huh?
Hey, there you go.
So.
Okay. More scouts out there sneaking in. Okay, Chief Phillips.
As I reported last meeting, our electronic road sign's been ordered, not installed yet. We have the old one removed. Should be installed soon. PJ, the Memorial Day parade, we plan on being up here. Have you notified the sheriff's office?
Yeah, everybody's letters fall going out. Yeah.
Okay. We'll be here. That's it for my report.
It's Sunday at 9 a.m. is when the parade's going to step off from across the street. Over here at the school, and do a short little parade up in here. And scouts generally come along and help us out, too. And we look forward to seeing you there. And usually draws a pretty good crowd of Auburn Township residents there to salute our
veterans and commemorate Memorial Day. And in fact, Carl, we've got we volunteered you for donut pickup again. Is that going to work?
Yes.
Good. Good. Museum's getting dialed up a little bit. We're going to do some bicentennial things, not with the ceremony, but in the museum. So there'll be some 200-year commemoration refreshments up there. I think we're getting a cake and whatnot. Thanks for bringing that up. Just thought we might as well mention that now while we're on board with it. Thank you, Chief.
That was a good segue to your report.
Which has something to do with that. We mentioned before that the playground installation is going on right now. They're going to replace some of that used equipment that really kind of kicked the whole thing off that we got from Gardner School. You know, some edge cracked or got roughed up, and there's a $175 replacement. I've worked on that plastic piece for that piece of equipment. But Playground World has, you know, we talked at length about that we need a certified installer and everything like this, you know, because there's liability things when we put a playground in. He's offered to come out on whatever schedule we set up to do a re-inspect and a kind of an updated, keep ahead of the stay on, you know, a course where everything's certified, where you don't have a broken piece or this, that, or the other thing. So I told Nancy, I said, you know, once a year, maybe every other year. It depends on, you know, some of the old stuff that we put in there. It depends on how that holds up. But
yeah, I think it'd be prudent. I just get a bid at it.
This guy's been pretty good to work with. Of course, he's made some money here, but he's been very helpful, and I really did a good job with that disassembly and reassembly of that free stuff that we got to get the whole thing started. Chagrin, there's a note here somewhere. I shuffled it in, I'm sure, but Chagrin Watershed Partners wants to hold on one of their meetings. They do generally a quarterly meeting. They want to do one in September at Adam Hall. Approximately 40, sometimes you get 50, 60 people at the most.
I have no problem with this.
We're members. About a two-hour meeting at the most. There's maybe some light refreshments. I think we should certainly agree to host that.
Yeah, I agree. I mean, we're part of the thing. Yeah, you can just get a small, you know, outside group like that, just to get some visibility on the whole thing.
The date was September something. Did you see? I saw a note here on it. I know it just came through today.
When Nancy mentioned it to me, I told her
All right, so here's my motion. I'm just going to make a motion that we host the September meeting, Spring River Watershed Partners, at a date to be scheduled with Nancy.
Okay, I'll second.
It's a weekend. So
I'm sure we're PJ?
Yes.
Mike?
Yes.
Had a bicentennial meeting last week. Things actually kind of fallen into place a little bit. The next thing we need to focus on is that weekend of July 2nd and on through the 4th. Nancy's been in contact with the Dale Mitchell from Bainbridge. We got to nail this down. How much we're gonna have a little tent, I guess, with maybe some memorabilia and maybe a monitor showing our screenshot thing Nancy did of the buildings. And. And do you meet with Bainbridge pre-fireworks show yet? Or?
No, we got that down so bad that we don't have any meetings on it anymore.
We need to know what we're doing there. Did they want...
Well, Dave Mitchell is going to set us up a tent.
How big's a tent?
I can get you the exact size.
That's what we need to know. How big's the tent? How many tables? Is there any expectation of something? Does it need to be taken down that night of the 2nd.
No, so Dave said he was going to, because he was putting up the tent for Bainbridge anyway. He said he'd put one up for us, he'd put it up, he'd take it down.
Well, I'll tell you what, get us a size okay. So we have some idea. So we're going to raid the museum is what we're going to do, mm-hmm. You know, for the most part. We're getting that timeline thing blown up into a banner kind of thing. There's a requisition form for that. That'll be part of the display. But, yeah, we kind of looking forward to how much stuff do we need to have a good show there.
Yeah, because originally, I guess, we discussed just because they were going to have a tent. Mm-hmm. And, you know, they were going to give us part of it. And Dave came up with we have a lot of tents, so I'm just give you your own tent. So, I mean, do you have a preference for size?
You know, as we're having this meeting here, Nancy's picturing like the Grange Hall at the county fair.
Giant circus.
Yeah, that's what she's picturing. And I'm picturing maybe a little tent with two tables approximately this size. I don't know. You know, so that's...
Well, I'll ask what size theirs is going to be and... And if we have any options,
we've got volunteers to set it up, and we've got I think we have some volunteers, but we're looking for more. Of course, we're gonna have people in the tent during the day.
No, if I'll see what they're planning on using for theirs. I mean, if we have a comparable, it makes more sense if we have comparable size areas. Or
it would look better. It would look good more uniform. Yes. Yeah. So yeah, let us know what we're. What we're into there, we might need to do some display cases for some. Yeah, you know, there's some delicate stuff up there that looks kind of cool, but you don't want to throw it in the back of your car or the back of the pickup truck, you know what I mean?
Right.
So we want to get organized with that.
Got to watch for bad weather, too.
Well, sure. Yeah, that's kind of why we were wondering about is it going to. Can we move it into the school overnight? Do we have to tear it down that night? You know, post fireworks, get kind of late there, you know. How's that all going to work?
Yeah.
So. That's about all I got for tonight.
All right.
Okay. Get your regular reports in front of you. Including payment listing report for warrants 3786 through 3876, totaling $90,717.66. Plus, there is a warrant that is not on your report, that is a draw for Mr. Jim Dixon for his work on the Anna Hall project. And that is a warrant for $5,000. So we totaled $95,717.66. Of note is warrant 3798 to Hubble Construction for $44,579.52 for work performed at Adam Hall so far. Also a warrant to Hubble Construction for $17,619.52. That was our last payment on the construction contract for the service garage. And I believe that's still going to be held while a couple of kinks are worked out on something.
Right. Okay. It's a warrant for Jim 3815?
60. 38.
60.
What's 50? You also have your appropriation status summary, revenue summary, and fund summary. We are looking towards getting our second half tax advance for this year in July. And I have a resolution here, resolution 2017-17. And I will read it in the record. This is to request the tax advance. Be it resolved by the Board of Trustees of Auburn Township, Geauga County, Ohio, that it must request its second half fiscal year 2017 tax advance by July 12, 2017, and that such advance is required to maintain township operations. Therefore, the board authorizes the fiscal officer to make a written request to the Geauga County Auditor for said tax advance pursuant to Ohio Revised Code 321.34.
So moved.
Second.
Okay. And going out of order, I need money for, this is principally for the electronic sign at the fire station.
A portion.
Resolution 2017-15 for supplemental appropriations. Be it resolved by the Board of Trustees of Auburn Township, Geauga County, Ohio, that the following supplemental appropriations shall be made: $9,000 in the Fire Levy Fund, $2191760-740, account name Machinery, Equipment, and Furniture.
Okay, so moved.
Second. Yes.
Mike? Yes.
And I have another resolution for an inter-fund transfer of money. And this is, I'm asking the board to approve a transfer of $136,547, which is representative of cable TV franchise fees and estate tax settlements, and to put that in our land acquisition and improvement fund.
Okay.
So I'll read the resolution. Be it resolved by the Board of Trustees of Auburn Township, Geauga County, Ohio, that the following interfund transfer shall be made: $136,547 from the general fund to the land acquisition and improvement fund, said amount representing $60,000 in cable TV franchise fees and $76,547.69 in estate tax settlements. The fiscal officer shall appropriate $136,547 in general fund account 1,910,910, transfers out to affect the interfund transfer.
What about 69 cents? It's about to get you in trouble.
And 69 cents.
Now is that a motion?
Yeah, it is.
Second.
PJ?
Yes.
Mike?
Yes.
Now, this is, Fred, you've explained this in the past. This is, we acknowledge all the receipts when this comes in from cable funds and estate, you know, the rest of the estate tax stuff that we're going to see. And
right.
We always, do, I think, regularly make the motion to put that to land acquisition and improvement, but you have to put it in the general fund first.
Correct.
That's
it goes into the
so
general
this
fund.
Just kind of...
And we have to formalize
it. We've already
it by,
done this.
We've already done this, yeah.
But we have to formalize
gotcha.
It by putting in the transfers
right.
out.
Okay, thanks.
The estate, and the estate taxes actually came in April. And so that's, I don't think we've addressed that one at all. That was all from one estate.
Okay, good.
That's all that I got.
Okay. I'd say we're close enough to the 8 o'clock hour to go ahead with the bid openings.
Seems like you track of these. bid is from Chagrin Valley Paving.
Now, what's the project credit and the estimate, please?
For the asphalt resurfacing of section C and D of Taylor Main Road, and the estimate should be at the top of the tally sheet.
Original estimate is $270,000.
Total contract price from Chagrin Valley is $217,347. They included their bid guarantee box. Now, for the same project, we have a bid from Ronyak Paving. Total contract price is $233,857. And they included a guarantee. Okay. The next project is the chip seal of various roads in Auburn Township. Jogga County Engineer estimate is $215,000. Bid is from Specialized Construction Incorporated. Total contract price from Specialized is $227,300. And included their bond. Bid is from Asphalt Fabrics on the same project. Bond is included. Total contract price is $214,400. Bid on that same project is from Ronyak Paving. Guarantee bond is included. And the total bid is $240,225. The next project is the asphalt resurfacing of various roads in Auburn Township, including Riverwood Lane, TR 680, Auburn Springs Drive, TR 956, Cumberland Trail, TR 998, and Firewood Trail, TR 999. Jogga County Engineer project estimate is $350,000. First bid is from Chagrin Valley Paving. The total bid amount is $266,925. Second bid on that project is from Ronyak Paving. The total bid on that contract is $278,828.75. And they include again. That's all of them.
Fred, are you going to hold on to those? Do you want to mail those out, scan those, and have Nancy send them to us so we can review them? How do you want to handle that?
Yeah, I think I'll have Nancy scan those and send those out to you.
Okay.
If that works for you.
That works. If she gets them tomorrow, then I can get a bid review and get the recommendation back to your by your next meeting.
Okay, good.
We're 3 weeks to our next meeting, so our next regular is what, June 5th?
Yeah. June 5th.
Okay.
Question, gentlemen, or Fred. The second, on the chip seal, there were three bids. The middle one, can you repeat that name? It was, the last part of it was Corbett's.
Do you have that right now?
It was Asphalt Fabric.
Asphalt Fabrics and Specialties.
Asphalt Fabrics. Okay, that was on the chip seal, correct?
Correct.
Okay.
There's three of them. Specialized Construction, Inc., Asphalt Fabrics and Specialties, and Roniak.
Gotcha. Thank you.
Mike, would it be okay if I head out the door?
Yeah.
Thank you.
Thank you.
It gets pretty exciting from now on, but if you know, you guys want to leave, feel free. Yeah. We kind of work our way up to a crescendo, you know. Okay.
Real quick, Mike. Hard though.
Good.
There's no turn yet. That's how to reach me. It sells
out. Thank you.
Thank you, Emmerich.
You're welcome, Mike. Have a good night.
We just need Emmerich here to give those guys an evil eye in case they. Okay. Let's go back to old business. Appoint a BZA alternate.
I would make a motion. We had resignations. Warren Bauer left. I'd make a motion to we interviewed Ms. Crone.
Yes.
Yeah. Where are we empty right now? Two alternates.
Well, Bob left, and Sarah, or what's her name, just resigned. So we are down to.
We are to down to. Who's the full term?
I don't know.
Yeah. We haven't appointed David Parker, who has been on and off. David's not in a position right now, is he?
No.
I'll make that motion tonight. Appoint David Parker as BZA alternate.
Okay. I'll second.
BJ?
Yes.
Mike?
Yes.
David's been
done a good job for us.
Yeah, he's been. He had to leave a couple times with work issues, but we just mentioned, we need some people that can step right in. So at this point, let's put Dave on, and then we'll fill that second alternate position there in short order.
Okay. Second under old business. CERNAs is, they're asking if we would like to have a request a hearing on CERNAs liquor permit for the pizza place. And again, this is a beer and wine permit with sales up to 1 o'clock. Check with the Sheriff's Office. They have no complaints or have any problems with CERNA's other operations, so I would make a recommendation that we do not request a hearing.
And a motion? Yes, I'll second that.
So Fred, yeah, you can go ahead and if you got the original, it says you can sign it off on it.
Okay.
Send it in.
Yes.
Right? Yes. So just check off that we don't want to not requesting a hearing. One below it.
No.
There you go. Thank you, Fred.
Jim.
Okay. The last. On the new business, the 2017 crack seal project. Legal ad will be going out 5/18. With the bid deadline opening on 6/5.
Okay,
should we do that at 8 o'clock? Is it open?
Jim, you got an update for us on?
I have received drawings back from zoning today to submit for a building permit for the addition to Adam Hall. That's, the floor is done, so we're now going to wait for permits to do the addition, and once we get those, we'll start construction. That's pretty much it. Everybody seems really pleased with the floor.
Nancy was very pleased with it, and she's our biggest critic, so if you get past her, you're in good shape.
Do we need to move on that crack seal project?
Is there a motion? No, it's, well.
Yeah.
Oh, sure, I'll make a motion to be advertised for the crack seal project. Yes.
Mike?
Yes.
And that'll be your 8 o'clock.
Right.
All right, we got to adopt some fees for our large item cleanup day, which is going to be Saturday, June 3rd, 8 a.m. to 1 p.m., and we're going to do it in the big parking lot at Adam Hall. It just seemed to flow pretty well up there. We'll get the dumpsters up there. People seem very aware when they see six dumpsters out there in the yard that are doing something like that. Car and small truck, $7. Full-size truckload, $10. Bring 8 tires at a time. There's no charge for that. Take them on or off rims. No liquid paint, rocks, yard waste, household garbage, or hazardous materials. Put all small stuff in the strong boxes or containers. Unbroken car batteries, we'll take those. So that's our fee schedule, and we should not doubt that again.
And just a reminder that as part of that, the senior trash pickups on June 1st and 2nd. And anybody wanting to take care of that service, you have to pre-register with the Geauga County Department of Aging. You can't go through us. They're doing all the coordination, even though our guys are picking up.
Somehow we weren't listed as a community that was participating. I think they fixed that. I know we got right on that. So I don't know how we were left off the list, but we were, and we are participating. We have all along. So there's a motion.
PJ?
Yes.
Mike?
Yes. Okay.
Never seen a proposal from Kodash Excavating.
This is it's equipment labor to replace road cross culverts. The Kodash Excavating. Included day rate for a 320 track hoe and a 416 backhoe with operators and labor and all needed tools and safety equipment, pumps, saw, etc. 8-hour day is $25.50. So I'll make that motion.
Yeah, without, I don't want to make it without committing to any 8-hour days as of yet, but that's kind of...